Yes, we walked in the bedroom, and I said, well, let's go ahead and get your measurements. And so he immediately took off all his clothes, which he had never done before.
And did he show that to you?
Well, yeah, when he took off all his clothes.
And where were those clothes deposited?
Right by his feet where he was standing, right inside the door of the master bedroom. But when we finished the measuring, he turned around and went and jumped in the middle of the bed and said, okay, let's tie me up before she comes.
He asked you to restrain him?
Yes, but I said, look, I don't think that's a good idea. So he said, well, I'll tie my legs. I'll go ahead and tie my ankles. And so he did. And then he said, well, you do my arms. And I said, no. I said, I'll tie one arm in a slip knot. But that's all I'm going to do. It was his right arm.
His right arm?
Yeah. His left arm was totally free for a slip knot anytime he wanted to get out and get up or whatever.
Okay. Now, you noticed the photographs that were presented by the state and the fact that they had robe, R-O-B-E, robe belts, and they had also had some male ties, like you and I wear a tie to our shirt. Those were tied to respective corners of your bedpost, correct?
There were none of these kind of ties. There were robe ties. I have a lot of robes because I keep them out when I have guests.
Okay.
So I have a lot of robes. And the vet taught me that robe belts were perfect for walking your dogs. It's so called a light leash.
That's how the dog hairs got on one of them, right?
Yes, and that, and the youngest one, Boozer, loved to get in and grab them. He's a hoarder. So he'd get in and unload them and take them under the bed and hide them.
Okay.
Well, they were the tug-of-war toys, too.
Okay, so you tied them to the bedpost to prevent the dog.
Yeah, because I had to run to Winn-Dixie, and I have vertigo, too, and I can't get down and look under the bed to pull them out.
Okay. After he was restrained with his own consent and permission, the way he described, what's the memory you have of anything that happened then?
I had to use the bathroom again. That's another thing of diabetes, is if you're drinking beer, you have to go to the bathroom a lot.
Okay. Did you go to the bathroom?
Yeah, and it's right there in the master bedroom. So I said, I got to run to the restroom.
Okay. When you got to the restroom?
When I was heading out, he said, I want to get up now, off the bed. I said, okay, just pull the slip knot. He said, well, I did, but it stuck. And I said, okay, I'll get it up. I'll pull it and get you right up.
Did you release the slip knot?
Yes. And then I gave him a paring knife from the kitchen and said, you know, go ahead and get yourself up and I'll talk to you later. I'm going to take the dogs out because I hadn't taken them out since they eaten. Plus, it had been raining, so they hadn't been much out at all during the day.
Do you ever have any kind of sexual intercourse with that young man?
Nothing. I didn't ever even take my clothes off. I mean, nothing at all.
Did you sleep in the same bed?
Yes.
On the same bed sheets?
Yes.
And the same pillowcase?
Yes.
And you were naked?
Yes. When I slept?
When you slept. Understood. Judge, I have any further of this witness at this time?